questions on .NET, questions on C#, questions on ASP.NET Core, the works. We've got to 25,000 subscribers on this channel. Thank you very much. So to celebrate, we're gonna grab a coffee and obviously a Dreamcast mug and read 25 of my viewers' comments and questions. I'm gonna regret this, I have a feeling. Starting with this guy, 0xd4ngi, says, great video. Will there be the same number of job opportunities for a .NET developer in the next 5 years as it was in the last 15 years at Ted's Tech? Dead naming me there, fantastic. I am just starting out my freelance journey as a .NET developer. Well, let's just say I hope so. If Microsoft do their job properly, promoting C# and .NET, which I hope they do, then yes. I'm going to say yes. I'm actually quite positive about this. C# is having a renaissance. So that's good news for everyone. Next up, Patboy24 says, is it okay to jump right to learn WPF after learning C# instead of ASP.NET MVC because I want to build desktop app? Yes, actually the answer is yes. A couple of years ago, I would have said no, but WPF is having a renaissance, just like C# in general is. And Microsoft are actually investing time and stuff into WPF. Again, it's actually something they would recommend, which I think is pretty good. Next up, HeavyMetal116 says, it makes me wonder why Blazor is not widely used, despite the fact it is a strong alternative to React and Angular. Ooh, question mark. You can make a video regarding this. There are probably more business reasons why you would want to use React or Angular versus Blazor. So let's just, it's not just about the technology. You've got to think about the impact on your project and your company and your hiring and everything else. I would still, at the moment, until Blazor gets a little bit more adoption in the software development world, to stick with React or Angular or HTMX, because that's really cool. I'm not going to make a video on this because it might get a little bit too spicy for the channel. Next up, Flavor Lani Pekun 4297 says, you seem to use VS Code in your videos and not Visual Studio. Any special reason for that? It's lightweight and it runs on a Mac. Visual Studio does not run on a Mac. And I use a Mac as my main host, even though most of the time for corporate enterprise work, I am logging in through remote desktop to a Windows machine to use Visual Studio. If I have a preference, I will use VS Code on the Mac host. Next up, what is the difference between Azure OpenAI GPT-4 and using directly OpenAI's API? So I'm assuming this Mada is referring to Azure OpenAI service, of which I've done a video on. I've been using directly OpenAI API for more than a year, and I want to know the differences and advantages, if any. Well, okay, on my five things Azure does that AWS does not video, the last item is about this. And primarily the advantage is that using Azure OpenAI service, the models are all running within your corporate tenant. And this is important to security and enterprise people. There are actually a couple of things that Azure OpenAI service is currently missing, particularly around the assistance API. But that's a whole nother video. So maybe I'll do that in the future. Next up, Uche Ekuma says, hey Ted, dead naming me again. Love your content. What roadmap would you recommend to a junior dev looking to one day become an MVP like yourself? One, I'm not at the time of making this video a Microsoft MVP, but I'm flattered. Roadmap wise, you should check the Microsoft documentation. They actually pay people full time to write the documentation, and it's brilliant. Don't rely on YouTube free content, please. Obviously, you know, Nick Chapsis, he's doing his Dome Train stuff these days. And I would actually recommend that over Pluralsight if you do want to open your wallet for some courses. Next up, Philippe V34444 says, I've used .NET quite a bit for open API development and decided to read the book Professional C# and .NET by Christian Nagel, maybe? Man, the amount of C# features I didn't even know is insane. I can handle it, because I already know Java, Python, some web stuff, but for a beginner, it's way too much. I'd even say C is a better language to start with instead of C#. Philippe, I agree with you. I think C# is getting too complicated. Every year, they add loads of new features, half of which nobody actually asked for. They're getting a lot of inspiration from TypeScript and things like this. And yes, TypeScript is one of the languages, but if it's going to turn into a different language, why not just get that different language, for example, TypeScript, to run on the CLR? The CLR was supposed to run lots of different languages. It runs C#, it runs F#, it runs Visual Basic.net. But why not run TypeScript.net as well? That would be so cool. JavaScript is dealing with different runtimes. So you've got Bun now coming out instead of Node, which is pretty cool. So why can't the CLR run TypeScript? It's types, right? I'd prefer they did that rather than just whack stuff onto C# every year, which is confusing people. Next up, I think this is a big one. Here we go. Metal Typhoon. Agreed with 90%. Well, I'm thank you. Thank you. 90%. It's pretty good. This is what I don't agree with. The debating. This is pretty cool. MVC. Don't do this. Use minimal APIs. This is how most web APIs are done in other languages. Yes, that's why they did minimal API. Because instead of advocating for MVC patterns, such as Rails, they decided to do minimal APIs to make it, in theory, easier. MVC is dated and you can pick this up later. I still think you should learn MVC first. I will put my foot down on this. Primarily because with minimal APIs, there's nothing to learn. It's so simple. Clean code. This book has so many questionable advice. Might as well read What Good About It online. Too much better books. You still should read the book. It's a classic. Please just read it. Learn basic SQL and then Postgres and MySQL, world outside Microsoft. Yes. So my video, I recommend learning MS SQL because in the majority of enterprise .NET shops where you might want a job, MS SQL is highly likely to be the database used. So just get some experience in it. It doesn't mean you can't use something else. But you certainly, I would be very worried if a .NET resume came across my desk and they haven't even installed haven't even installed SQL Server, Express Edition, can't use SSMS, and so on. Just get some experience. Whew, getting tired. Duff Mandj says, one thing I would think is worth mentioning, and maybe it's part of the learn C# bit, but I would have mentioned learning async patterns. That's pretty good. I've been doing .NET for a long time. I'm pretty mediocre dev in that regard. Mostly did small and support size project. And the leap when async was released was very hard for me to overcome. I still don't get it, to be honest. Well, it's better than it used to be with background workers and stuff, and you had to roll your own async. The point of async is that you don't have to think about it. You write code in a synchronous way. Maybe I should do a video on async. But I mean, it was introduced in .NET Framework 4.5, so we're talking a very long time ago. Watch the Microsoft videos on it. All right, Rankerat. Hello, Rankerat. I agree with everything except the part about Blazor. Using MVC will not help you understand Blazor better. Well, what I'm saying is you don't need to understand Blazor. Before approaching any web framework, including Blazor, it's essential to have a solid understanding of CSS, HTML, and JavaScript. However, these days, you should avoid any .NET-related UI frameworks that are not Blazor. So my advice on this to do SPA front-end work in React and so on, first, so that your skills are transferable outside the .NET world. This is actually important for your general health and being able to feed yourself as a software developer. It's going to get harder and harder to stay a pure .NET dev that never touches anything else. Seriously, do Blazor. It's very clever, but my running theory at the moment is that it's actually for very advanced users. It's not for beginners, because you need to be able to make the trade-offs you need to be able to understand the trade-offs in terms of the technology and what it means for your business by using Blazor in the first place. And you need to be an expert to be able to make that call. All right, Kennedy. YMWender 3357 says, I disagree on databases. Oh, yeah, another guy. For some of us, Windows is not our primary OS, thus MS SQL Server will not be our first choice. Please understand that doing C# and .NET stuff not on Windows is still quite esoteric. It's quite a unique setup. It's getting more and more popular these days, but the vast majority of jobs will still be doing it on Windows. And if you're on Azure as well, you'll probably be doing it on SQL Server. Personally, I built Windows to fix legacy Visual Basic applications. Good for you. MS SQL Server for Linux was being developed. It was, you're right. I still wouldn't use it in production. I don't think anybody would sign off on doing that. A few years ago, did MS ever finish that project? Not sure. Would it ever be finished? Considering that they just released ARM-based Copilot Plus PCs that you cannot run SQL Server on, because it just doesn't work at all. It's an unsupported CPU, doesn't even run under emulation. I don't get my hopes up. All right then. Unisonral 1171. I'm 70 years old. Man, legend. And I started to learn .NET Core last year. I'm good at building console application, and I've started with ASP.NET MVC. Next year, I plan to learn some vanilla JavaScript. Thanks to channel owner for your honest advice. God bless you. No, God bless you, Mr. 70-year-old or Mrs. 70-year-old. This is heartwarming. This is that warms the cockles of my heart. Wow. That's great. That's cool. Right, this next comment. Okay, here we go. Pazoto says, read clean code despite his politics. What kind of is that? I appreciate that you still tell people to read his book. Yes, as it is an available book for programmers, but I take a guess that you wouldn't read it because he does not agree with your political beliefs. Well, I have read it, so I wouldn't not read it. So that makes no sense. I firmly believe that you can separate somebody's professional or creative output from their political beliefs. And I'll leave it at that. You didn't mention Xamarin. Not sure if this framework is still usable or not. It's being deprecated. Don't use Xamarin. Look at .NET MAUI, if that's your thing. Why stay clear of SOAP and WSDL? I am reading a book that has that stuff in now. Yes, but it's an old book on web services. Am I wasting my time learning this? Is this stuff now used anymore? I was planning to learn Java and Jakarta, and I thought this book would be a good preliminary book to read. Yeah, it is still being used, but most people are not creating new web services in SOAP and WSDL today. Therefore, your opportunity for employment in these skills, unless you want to be that the guy dealing with the super old enterprise tech, and you'll probably get paid a lot of money if you can do it and nobody else can't. You're not going to be doing new systems. So if you want to do new systems to stay interested in writing code, just you don't need to learn it. In fact, probably today, anything, if you ever got stuck with it, you'd just ask your favorite large language model for the answer, wouldn't you? All right. Lindo says, 15 plus years .NET experience here. This is solid advice. What a joke. Yeah, okay. Yeah, that's actually a pretty good joke. Next up, oh my God, okay. I'm looking at options for a very big microservices project with a very small number of developers. Stop it, stop. Don't do that. I spent a few hours looking at Orleans, I suppose, a few days ago, and was really impressed. It's good. What else to evaluate? Let's look at Azure Function Serverless. It auto scales, right? Today I spent literally the whole day trying to work out what the latest story is for Azure Functions. It's a complete mess. Improc is becoming obsolete. Azure Portal says it's obsolete. Yeah, okay. And this guy keeps going. Thank you for doing my Azure Functions research for me. This is a comment, just a comment on one of my videos, by the way. New Azure Function Flex consumption plan does not publish on VS. Misleading documentation. Some places say that .NET 6 is at end of life. Yeah, okay. Easy to focus on Microsoft or Orleans and forget about Azure Functions. Am I wrong? No, you're not wrong, sir. This is Cole Houndtech. You're not wrong, buddy. Microsoft Orleans does not have a dependency on your hosting environment. It can run on anything. So that's why I prefer it. I don't like writing code that has dependencies on the hosting environment or a specific cloud provider. Just codes yourself into a corner, doesn't it? Can 40 years old be able to get a job in the industry as a full stack developer if he is able to build an app at .NET? Yes, why not? 40 is the new 25. Sir, I'm from South Africa. I have 3-year experience. I've never seen any post that needs new students from university for .NET developers who need 5+ of experience. Yeah, CJ, it's tough out there right now. Don't know really what to say, other than keep your head down and keep studying, and hopefully something will happen to the economy that turns this round. Next up, still Matt West says, great video and advice. Interesting that .NET has embraced React. Yeah, Microsoft Teams is written in React. Because it is. I haven't worked in a .NET environment for about 5 years. They were all about Angular back then. There was a phase for applications built about 5 years ago where Angular was very popular with .NET. See it less these days for new apps. Also interesting is that MVC is still the starting point rather than API endpoints to use with React. This is just my opinion, but you can build APIs with MVC controllers. Still, believe it or not. Dandyson 6116 says, this video has been more helpful than other 1 hour or more videos about what you need to know. Oh, thank you, Dandyson. Very kind. Simple, concise, and to the point. Liked and subscribed. Thank you. And viewers out there, if you're still watching this video, thank you, because it's really long. But please like and subscribe. It helps me make more stuff. Right, back to this guy, Dandyson. Thank you so much for this. Well, no, thank you for watching, Dandyson. I appreciate the comment. Hi, I really like your teaching style. I can see the effort you're putting in. Well, this video is particularly low effort, but thank you. Have you ever thought about making tutorials? They seem to get good views. Yeah, the problem is with tutorials is that they don't actually get good views, and they don't get high quality views. And they don't get repeated views. And if you're not on somebody's payroll to make tutorials, they're not much fun to do. They take a lot of work for little to no output. I'd rather kind of talk more general about technology, because it's more fun, and this is my channel, and I'm going to do what I want to do on it. F-sharp is easier than C-sharp. Functional programming is just different, but more straightforward to the point. Yes. For some people. Now, considering that Marcos here, you have an anime avatar on YouTube, this means that you are a man of culture and probably of super high intelligence. Therefore, F-sharp might be easier for you. But for the vast majority of people, I don't think it is. Now, I did promise in the last video to give a shout out to any startup using .NET and C#, and we have a couple of comments. Begin says, Quotation Factory, fifth year of our startup, MS Orleans-based backend. Good choice. Microsoft Orleans is amazing and one of the best things to come out of Microsoft DevDiv in a very long time. And we have another one. My company, we are three developers, are doing new web apps with .NET Core MVC or API and React on the front end. See, it's a very good choice there. 100% agree. Stay away from Blazor. It's up to you. You don't have to. There are some scenarios where Blazor is good. Stick with MVC and JavaScript as a good alternative to Microsoft Stack. I recommend Spring Framework. Yeah, it's in the Java world, isn't it? Especially if you're using other databases than MSSQL or just want to stick more to an open source stack. Cool, that's two shout outs. Didn't give the name of his startup, but there you go. I'll give Michael, Michael Astley, I think, a shout out there. And that's it. Thank you for watching. I've still got half a cup of coffee because I've been talking too much, but don't forget to like and subscribe. If you leave a comment, I will probably reply to it. Actually, no, I will either heart it and reply to it. And I might even do another video like this in the future. Thanks for watching.